they have done. The only thing is that we have been able to now add a lot to what they have done. You will see that the labs are having a lot of equipment now, but we still need more. So let us go around and show you as much as we can. This one is called Concrete and Structural Lab. You see the heat of the first, of the former products of what we have done. We do practical work and we do community service in the sense that the construction that is going, the central bank project that is going on here, most of the evaluation of their materials and testing of the concrete of the materials are done in this lab. For cross velocity tester, it tests the strength of concrete without necessarily breaking down the building. If, for instance, the building is already standing and you need to do the testing of that strength of that material, you don't need to break down the entire structure like that one would do. This one can only preserve the structure and is still going to give you desirable.
We call that one the non-destructive
testing machine.
Why that one?
That we have a machine that does the
modern testing.
Yes, I was surprised when I saw it in the result that that's what we are using. What we normally use this one for is to actually read the temperature of the wall, because we normally calculate the U value to be able to know the heat transfer, the temperature of the wall in and out, so that we're able to calculate the heat transfer. Now we have this one. This place is actually Building Science and Services Lab. We study the science of building materials and we also carry out services. Services is electrical and mechanical. So there are two different workshops here. This side is mechanical, while this side is electrical. Now, the type of buildings and building problems, and give students group by group. And they develop, they have been doing this over time now. And we have so many of them, but we have to select the ones that make a lot of sense. Adafa has simulated a borehole, normal borehole that we know in that tank. That tank is our borehole. The borehole has what we call submersible pump, and it has a surface pump. The idea of this is for somebody to know how submersible pump operates and how surface pump operates and how it can be installed and water collected and the piping is done. Now, I don't know whether there's enough water there, but if there's enough water, Mr., you can see and test. Yes, you can see water will come here, you can see. What we were trying to do recently was to now integrate this kind of system to another life small building, where if you put this one on, the water runs in this tank, through this, all these pipes that you have done, to come out from somewhere. And I think I've challenged him, that's the next stage that we're now trying, so that the students will also now see how we have been doing this all the years, but we have not gone to the extent of integrating it into another view. So that's the next level, and that's what you will see some of the tanks that the students are also producing there. All these ones were also fabricated in the workshop there. This is level. We have three different of this in the entire department. So these ones were worked here. They were existing before, but they were all destroyed. So now we work this one and obtain several other boards, because these ones are actually generated, and I can tell you that a lot of my staff are doing their best to see how the last can work. Yes. Because even though I'm a professor of building, but they are now professors of new things that are coming up. Now they have been able to learn some of the softwares that are available in the market. So a lot of them can do AutoCAD, which is specifically in the purview of the architect. But they went further to now learn Orion and some other software packages that will enable them to carry out structural design, architectural design, and building services, mechanical and electrical. And I think where service
We will show you some of the things that he has also done in the area of structural design. We will show you in the this is one level. I was wondering, I had to interview the student that time he was doing. I said, I'm not sure whether you are the one that is doing this by yourself. If you look at the choice of material, you know, at that time, I didn't even, he said, he went through some other programs. So you can see, you can, this is a penthouse, and the concept, when you see it in the drawing, it's so beautiful, and it stands the test of time, and it shows the construction process as well. Now, why we call this place Building Components as Exhibition Lab is that most of the components that you obtain from outside will normally come and put them here to show the different types of, I think there are some tiles and some other things that we left in the other place. Yes, so that you can see the nature of the tiles that our students use to mimic products like this. They will do research to get us something similar. This is a police station, I never liked it because I don't like the way all the time their buildings and everything does not always attract me, so this one does not attract me. Then this one is a hospital, also by the same set of students. These students I am talking about are 200 level students. Now, eventually, we have been doing all these models, and I now came up with an idea. I said, if we do models, can some of the models become also functional? And that is why I have had the idea of creating the other model that we are going to now eventually look at, so that you will now see that moving from theory to practice is what we are doing. The essence of all that we are doing is that we want to make sure that students do not just only learn in theory like this. They have drawn all this, but how do they couple all this? That is why you see very many low poor quality work all over the place, because people have not been able to pass through the tutelage of the practice that is required of them. So that is what we have made the students to also be part of. So let us quickly go to the other side. We will now go to the carpentry workshop before we finally go to our But NUC and NIOB requires that a worksheet should also be covered. We hope that the university will tap into this and see how they can help us. Yes, we are more interested for practicals. We're formally having this is metal workshop, and this is metal workshop, and this is workshop. They have what we call thinking lab, and that one is located in the youth environment, school of youth environment. Okay. And they have, okay. They also have what they call life building, life model. It's a building in a building, and that building in a building is done in a way that you simulate situations, you simulate life situations, you simulate weather situations. You can simulate any kind of load and see the behavior of those kind of simulated cases on the building. And a student came up with a drawing, and we now said, why can't we produce that drawing? And in the process of producing it, which Zaka was also the teacher, we discovered that there were so many errors. And we have some other people and who can do very fine work. Then we now commissioned Ndame again. Ndame is a graduate now. He has graduated. He's the best in that class. He made a 2-1, maybe he missed it. But he was able to give us a very good structural design and architectural design, and that we now used to now remodel, so that you can see the difference between what the former student did. The former student tried, but at his own level. Because that is the level. If it's perfect, then it shouldn't have been a student's work. But with those errors, we're able to now redo that same work, so that it will be easier for students to compare people think and what it is exactly. And when you look at this, the reason why buildings fail is not because buildings are inadequate, but because of lack of presence of builders. That is why buildings fail. Now, I want to say this and make it very clear. When you look at the built environment professionals, we have the architects, we have the builders, the quantities of the structural engineers, and the rest. But what each of them does is already enshrined in the building code. And that building code requires that the architect designs, the structural designer designs structurally and strengthens, while the builder, after the quantities of your cost estimates and manages, it is the builder that realizes all these dreams into one single world that will now look as final product of all the dreams.
And that's the one reason why the builder must know the work of the architect.
Yes.
Quantities of your, the land of your as well as.
Yes. Now we have our students that are almost like land surveyors now. They survey. They do survey. I follow them. I normally go to the field with them. Yeah, the campus. Now, let me say something here. This model has not finished. This model, what we intended to do and what we were doing was that we are going to have a complete building information model. You put the key and put the information here. So as you are teaching and as you are trying to study, once you click on that, you will see the information that is there and it will run through the information that you have. So that when you put this, you can see this. This is showing the short train for a column. And it is not just like this. The reason why buildings fail is not only the design. It is the construction failure sometimes. Now, if you look at from here to here, all these distances, they are calculated. They are not just put arbitrarily. In the field, people think it's done arbitrarily. It is not. Then when you look at all this, I think we simulated one. Look at this. You see, the slenderness ratio, yes, is not accurate. And that is why you can see the failure. I was telling the students, I'm saying this because the students are all here and the staff are also here. Some students were telling the students that actually worked on this in a way that is different from what we have been telling them in class. You have to know the work first, money will come. Students were also telling, where's the other boy? He has done so well that I need to mention. Where's Jude? Now Jude Mary was the one that did a lot of the cuttings of what we are doing there and some of the things that we did here. Jude Mary is only a 400 student. As he was working, some students were asking, how much are they paying you? It is not very good of the students. But not all the students, a few of the students said that. And I wanted them to, that the work is for the entire students. But only a few of them, the 20% that we are looking for, to achieve 80% success is what we got, and they are able to deliver this. Now when you look at this. When you look at the way we put the reinforcement, if you look at the top, these ones are called top reinforcement. Buildings fail because these top reinforcements sometimes are not appropriate. Yes, put. Look at all these ones at the middle. Now, look at something. When you look at these beams that you put here, the way you arrange the beams and the way you tie them, structural engineer may have done them correctly. But if the anchorage is not correct, the building can disconnect. And once it disconnects, that's failure. That's
even,
what we
even these lengths do.
Yes. All these lengths are not, yes. Sorry.
And if the reinforcement is not fixed,
yes,
it should be.
Yes.
There will also be a collapse.
If a collapse.
You usually say there is what we call a hugging moment.
Yes.
And the support.
Yes.
Why at the middle here we have sagging moment?
Yes.
Moment translates to the reinforcement, yes, and the type of reinforcement as well as the spacing of the reinforcement.
Yes. Yes. So now, this work, 200 level again, I think they are beginning to learn things that they have not. I think
I'm something about this.
Yes.
In the simulation thing,
yes,
what we are doing is that buildings are no longer being finished.
Yes.
When they are life cycle.
Yes.
But the simulated design, you are able to note the life cycle of the materials you put there.
Yes.
So that during moments of renovation, you can know what was there and just also, during the moments of construction, you are able to follow the pattern of each of the elements and you are able to tell what is happening at any point. So that's the idea of
school. Yes, and thank you very much. He's my president of Nigerian Institute. He was my president of Nigerian Institute of Building and the fellows. Yes, always the president is always the president. Now, sir, Mr. Vance's last time, each time we ask for what do you call it?
Plywood.
For plywood, they always insist that we should go and buy this plywood. And that makes it, even though he doesn't want to be part of that meeting, in the US, you can come and you listen to all the communications that are going on. And I think about Ben, I think about 2 days ago, I discovered the battery of that equipment just got spoiled. But I used it and it worked. And all I wanted was to demonstrate how you can put it in the boardroom. It's different from tracking. It's different from also video conferencing. Because it is a kind of a system that nobody knows that is there. But you can take part in that meeting without necessarily letting anybody know that you are part of that meeting. Thank you very much, sir, Mr. Vice Chancellor. We are now back to the final commissioning of our life model, which we are going to now demonstrate in the lab. Thank you very much, sir. In the there used to be a very big one that people used to use as a test. Okay. Yeah. From Cargo. Yes. Okay. Oh, that's good. Yes, I think you understand what happened here. This saw has not been properly set. So the ease with which it's cutting it actually is affected by the configuration of the saw. So you can see that the vice chancellor, I think the student, you can see what I'm saying now. It is not about it. We have already passed, we have the best grade in the world. But if you cannot transcribe that grade into practice, then of what use are you? So that is why we are teaching you how to do practical, so that theory and practice can make you a better person. Thank you very much. We can now go and go. No, it's true. Library is about, if you don't get something to present in the library, you are failed. Let me tell you why, Professor. When Carbon came, unfortunately, and NUC came, unfortunately, the entire library of the university has gone burnt. So there was no evidence, and 100% of all the books in environmental sciences got burnt. This library ended up being the saving grace for us. We went to him, he was able to do it. You will see Mr. Okwa, you will see Joe, Professor Joe, you will see all of us that have been contributing to this library. And when you come here, you will see there are many of them. The whole of this thing were acquired by individuals. So if we acquire them, we keep them in this place for students to come and read. You can see the students are there, we constructed these tables for them to be using. You can see some of the material. For the 3 volumes, they are very costly books.
It's okay. It's
yes,
okay.
And the, yes.
It's alright.
Okay. They are presented by Engineer Binchak to the Department of Building. And they are the key things, the key books that have been helping us of recent in our research. It's a very good he also doing. He has finished his PhD. Yes, he has finished his PhD. It's just that we are waiting for the approval of the upgrading for him to defend. So he has surprised me by the way he responded immediately after the. Because I just told him that the investor just got burnt, and he, all of a sudden he told me, he can also help. And he brought these books, and the books were the ones we now showed to all those teams that came. And it, and you see, one is A and one is Joel's is C and the other one is A. As written volumes over the years, we have been publishing and we keep publishing. And they say if you don't publish, we perish. These are our students' data, these are the projects that they have done, and I cannot. Faculty of Environmental Sciences category 2009. Professor Achuenu's PhD in 2001 was rated the best in the country also. Professor Achuenu supervised the PhD in the University of Uyo last year. He won also the 2012 category as the best PhD in environmental sciences. I didn't announce this because I didn't formally communicate the University of Uyo that I was helping them in that. But we thank God that something good has come out of that, and I did that with Professor Joe. That work actually was very fantastic, and it was about 4 of them, but only one can win. And all the 4, to be frank, all the 4 have the capacity to win. Anyone that is selected could have won, but the one that was lucky was the one that was selected, and that one
won the best PhD.
And Achuenu too. Candidate
who also
his first
degree. And MSc here. So he was an alumni of the University of Jos. And that makes it very novel too. And this is the fourth award that I can say I've successfully obtained from the NUC, which I think has made me to be very encouraged in the practice of building. Thank you, Mr. Vice Chancellor. So we are now going to...
We have been able to acquire, what do you call it? Inverters. The inverter is to serve that conference center, the library, and this particular place. And anytime somebody is here, if we now have the wireless, we have made the computer center over and over and over. But we have not been able to secure something that can bring the... so that each of these computers can also be networked, and we can also use Odeon and all the software to be able to use. We have our PowerPoint here for us to teach the students on how to use computer. I brought somebody from town, actually. He worked. Both the civil engineers wait for him. For him to do the analysis, both structural steel and concrete. I'm not joking, this is what's his name. He came here and they presented, they were the ones that taught some of the students. And the other one is Alpha. That one too, if you see what he does in modern design, you will not believe that they are better from the department.
Yes, they came out with
that. Yes, they come out with the class to me. But they did very well, and I think a lot of things have been done.
And what students have good.
We need to do a model that is live. We need a model, that can be applied. We need a model that can be that can really show what we can do. This model you are seeing is a very small model, but even in a senior building, even in Abuja, we can construct a kind of table like this that has all the facilities, even more facilities because of the difficulty we obtained in obtaining these facilities. You find out that I will explain how we came about some of these things. Now the concept is this: you will see the coat of arms of the foundation of the country, and that the foundation of the country is going to lift the University of Jos by the efforts put by the 20% that I told you to be able to achieve 80% of the results that we are desiring all the time to make the University of Jos the best in the world. If we continue like this, I know very well with the support of Nigeria, we will be able to reach the top. So Mr. Vice Chancellor, I'm now presenting this for you to be able to see. So we'll now go and see. We'll quickly give a summary of what we have done so far.
Yes, our best.
I have the pleasure to recognize the President, Vice Chancellor of the University of Jos, Professor Hayward Babale Mafuyai, President. We also have the Librarian at the University of Jos.
You are welcome to our boardroom designed, constructed and powered by the Department of Building. I am by name Professor Emmanuel, the head of the Department of Building of the Faculty of Environmental Sciences of the University of Jos, and incidentally the dean of the same faculty. There are a lot of my staff that are here. I have Professor Joe, who incidentally is the head of the Department of Quality Surveying. You are welcome. Next to him, by his right, is Builder D.D. Jambu, the past president of Nigeria Institute of Building and the chairman of College of Fellows, even though he has not given me my fellow. And I have another very prominent builder. That is Builder Captain. He is on sabbatical here. He is from the University of Yola. He is also a prominent builder and a member of the council. And I have before me Builder Itodu. He is a cancer engineer outside, but if we catch him, we will remove the engineer from him. He is a member of staff of the Department of Building.
And next to him is Yuda Mrs. Diego Adiabu. She is also a builder and a lecturer in the Department of Building, working seriously to complete her PhD. You are welcome. Right, he's a PhD in the University of Sheffield. And I also have Mr. Chindua. He's used to call him the HOD of the building. I don't know why they normally believe him, because we normally don't allow him to rest. Is Mr. Chindo, and that is the secretary, Mrs. Lohong. You can see she's a shining star with a very shiny face. And I have Mr. Tom. Mr. Tom was my structural engineer in that project we did in the lab, even though I was the designer and the the chairman and the board of directors. That's Mr. Tom. He did a lot in that thing. This is generally our examination officer. He did very well, and he's also doing his PhD. And that is Mr. Zaka, next to you. Mr. Paul Zaka entered this university as a graduate assistant. Unfortunately, at the time he got his job, the admission for MSc has closed. He applied for MSc, but because of logistic problems in the university, the admission was not true until not quite long ago, and he has finished his master's. But because of the policy of the university, the salary was dropped because by statutory provision of the university, he has spent the 3 years, but the opportunity to do the master's was not available at that time. I used to say I'm going to continue to plead with the vice chancellor if something can be done, because what he did in all this that we're talking about, you see me recalling his name everywhere. He has done very wonderfully well. If it were to be some Nigerians, that salary does not come, you will not see him. But he was always there, all the instructions are given. He was able to make sure that everything that we did here came to fruition. That is Mr. Ojo. Engineer Ojo is the one in charge of services lab. Engineer Ojo will never fail to surprise me, because when we're doing this thing, I will raise money. The university will bring their own. The projects we are doing aside, we will get. But sometimes we need to put a lot of our money to be able to achieve our result. When we got started, and what I do is that I look at the principle that is used in Singapore. And the principle has to do with develop the ideas, plan, and forget the money, and data together how the money will come. So what we normally do is first of all get the ideas and begin to see how you can do it. Look for the people. If you can't get the people, look for ways of getting the people. And from the process, you can now generate the funds. And that's why they talk about what they have to do. So when we're stranded in terms of being able to raise money to move ahead, otherwise if we don't get to this level, our efforts would have been wasted. I had to collect 200,000 from him to be able to power some of these things that we power here. I think he has done that several times, and I think I need to acknowledge that. Thank you very much. I think that in all the books that are here, I think those are the ones that I have. Okay, yes. I have the power that has grown into an artisan and now to another level. But he's also a workshop practice professional, because he knows so much about concrete practicals. He knows so many things about stock.
Just doing games like children doing computer games, so that they can get out and within this environment, try their hands on work, not just for science, but we will use such projects as teaching others. You can see that the university stands to gain a lot from what the department can do. We can save money for quality. I'm sure all the furniture that we have bought for the new faculties are compared. Well, let me be modest to say they may be able to compare with what we have. But I believe that we can. And you can save the university. We can also, as a department, give us the work and support. We will generate money to help you so that we don't really stress you more. Because we can turn these workshops into money-making ventures. I remember as a student in the airport, my department was making money for the student program. I was actually to do my PhD for a project supported by Martin Pike. And it came up from a camp paper as presented. Fortunately, I can't do that. We do our things here as well. We are academics, mothers, students, and students.
That would be a contribution. embarked on virtual services, which we have been doing before, and the students, like I said, are like journalists. If you see the video that they are showing them, this is the second part of what they are showing them. You found out that we have a documentary which the students were planning to launch.
All these days, they have tried and we have reached out to so many people. It's just that we have not been able to make a serious breakthrough. The sample of the video is as presented here. We went to the site here, the Central Bank building, and all of us went, and each of us delivered lectures on those sites, because the real lab for building practice is in the site. This one that we are seeing here are just first component of the lab, but the real lab and workshop is the site. So that's why we went to the site, went around, and each of the staff of the department, prominent staff, professors and eminent builders, were also interviewed, which the, like you remember, the NRUD were also telling you the anger they had with us was that we should have brought the documentary, they want to show it to the entire country. And they are also promised here that they want to, that they were inviting them to come and be our workshop here, as if you knew. They have already promised here that they want to sponsor all the students to what they call it a skills acquisition program, and they want it to be held here, and that NRUB will be willing to write off, especially that portion of that part of the sponsorship. So here before me,
an international conference.
Here before me is a video documentary that is produced by the Department of Building. It's in volumes. Several aspects of the documentary, they're not these ones. The ones that actually show the virtual visit is the side visit that we normally do, but we now put it in a soft copy. So I want to give you this when at your leisure time, you can watch. Thank you very much.
Everything that you've done here, what has been your experience in achieving this?
Yeah, thank you very much. First of all, I'm Professor Emmanuel, the head of the Department of Building of the Faculty of Environmental Sciences at the University of Jos, and the Dean of Faculty of the same university. The issue is that people like us who have passed through the polytechnic probably have that interest in practicals. And there's always an arbiter between theory and practice. Without transforming what is in theory into practice, the theory is meaningless. That is the motivating force in doing this. Now, like I mentioned earlier, the Department of Building of the University of Jos has done so many research works that have won morales. Like I mentioned before, more than four or five different awards have been secured from NUC as best PhD and best research awards. And the thing is that
without making all these dirty practices, nobody will know what they are. So the motivating force is to now showcase what is done in international level, at international level, how it can also be transformed here. That is the driving force. Then the difficulty that we have encountered, as you usually know, is funding. Even though there are models, models need money. The money in the same ratio in reality. So we usually encounter the same type of problems that we normally encounter in real construction process. And the only thing we are trying to do is to now leave this realm of research to the realm of theory and practice. And not only theory and practice, but theory, practice and development. So that is what we are. So we are trying to now make this place a springboard for jumping from classwork to what people can see. You know, builders, we don't advertise. It is our works that advertise for us. All those things you saw there advertised for us. So we are really ready to make this place an epicenter of research and development.
The message for the students?
Yes, the message for the students is that when Julius Vega came to this country, they started with quality. Quality gives money. It is not money that gives quality. I want them to understand that their products should speak for them. They are not going to advertise themselves. It is their work that will advertise for them. So I am encouraging all students, all Nigerian students, to make hard work their key driver, to make integrity their key driver, to make quality and any other thing that I think they should be free from courtesy, they should not put hand in terrorism, and they should also remember that God is the key owner of knowledge, and with God, they will reach the top.
For me, this is Wilder Jambo. For me, this is just one of the things that brought me to the university. I wasn't an academic staff, but when a challenge came that I employed a graduate of building who could not set out a rectangular building for me, I decided to come to the university in the year 2000. And since then, I've had two opportunities in this university, to head sideways and to come back to this department. While in sideways, today what you see as entrepreneurship was actually maybe I gave birth to. And went to the NUC, met the case, and through Professor Uber, pushed, and the program of entrepreneurship is on the curriculum of the whole Nigerian university. In fact, we pushed for, and in 2005, hosted the whole Nigerian university here at the University of Georgia to give birth to what we call the Teachers Industrial Work Experience Scheme, TIWES. Unfortunately, it did not take off because of the drive and funding. But all of that boils down to one. I'm an unrepentant apostle of experiential learning. I do not believe in theory only. I'm a very good theorist. I read and I research. But any theory that cannot be put to use ends up being a waste. I've been a startup man in many, many technological fronts in Georgia. Compressed earth bricks, I started with roofing tiles with fiber concrete and coconut fibers. I started here in Georgia in the 90s. I even developed a machine to vibrate and form the tiles. Unfortunately, I did not get any support. All I got were competitions and people trying to rival it without knowing why I was doing it. So back in the university, I see it as a good opportunity to turn this young, bubbling, energetic, intelligent students to what Nigeria wants. It can be done. And we believe strongly in this environment that we have made by experiential learning, that they will not just read and not be there. These boys are supposed to be very busy, that they will have no time for this week. And that's what we hope to see in this department. These workshops will transform them, will equip them, and will begin to get their hands on them until they are able to go out and beat matches and do what is needed. That's my job.
About the nature of the problems that we have had on collapsed buildings and things,
yes, we've said it time and over again, but people have not listened. If you saw the models, a building does not just come to be because it's kitchen. A building is produced. builders are those production managers. And our training is for building production management. That's why you can see that every element you manage its production process, from the mixing of sand, from the choice even of the sand, the choice of cement and water, and where you mix it, to the placement of the concrete, to the vibration, to the curing, to the striking off of homework, they're all management issues. People just think that you can just be. And that's why there's quackery, including those people who are sister professionals. And building collapse will continue for as long as we are practicing quackery.
Yeah.
If we can deal with quackery, we will solve it. And the builders are the key to solving that
problem. Thank you. Actually, it's a privilege to be a witness of today. And it's a joy in my heart to see that the vast we're going to make it to our department and to see our product and our students and also our proposal that we have raised forth. And we hope that as we have showed him all what we are capable of doing, we'll see positive results afterwards. And I'm really glad and happy to be among the members of the team that put up this event today, and it's a joy and a moment.
Do you have a future like this?
Well, we as a team, we are looking at seeing how we can bring into the building department journalism in building, whereby we do documentary on building profession. We call it the voyage of the building practice. Presently, the first edition, we titled it The Builder, The Masterpiece. And we are hoping that subsequently we'll come up with a concept whereby we bring out the practical experience of building into DVD, into CD, so that as we study in class, we're able to see how we can bring, we can see it visually also, so that we're able to marry the two together and get a better result, and also to create good understanding in our academics, because building is all about what you see. If you cannot see it, you can't understand it. So the more you see, the more you understand. So the video documentary is a way, the area where we feel that we can able to bring out that particular aspect. Thank you very much, sir. It's a pleasure, sir. Thank you.
First of all, my name is Chancellor, the second national vice president of the Department of Building, as National Association of Building Students. Firstly, when we came into the department, we met some those equipment you had going around to see. And from that time, 5 years back, because I'm at 500 level now, 5 years, improved, 5 years between then and now, the department have improved tremendously. And from what Didi Jambo told us, because that going to all the schools for accreditation, that this department has the latest equipment in the country. Well, the department has the latest equipment. Because others have, but they are not up to date. And all the equipment. And the projection as regard to what the VC has said is the department is already setting the pace, and the projection is that it will continue to set the to keep on track being the top university as far as building department is concerned in terms of lecturer, the equipment, and then student participation in the building environment.
My name is the point of corruption is not the vice chancellor that is
okay, but I love
the that was because we've been working with him in the area of the video documentary to take note of what has been happening in the department, what his administration has been able to achieve. And from the industry too, we were able to interview some engineers and all that to get some basic facts from them concerning what will be taught in the classroom to see if it is realistic on the science and still what it practice. So all these were case I visit to. And he was so happy with me because I took serious part in the making of the conference table. That was me and the man in the workshop. We came from the beginning to the end of the day. We were so compassionate about it. So that's one.